So let's take a look at the last type of joints, the prismatic joint. Again, I've created a scene here. I have a wall made of masonry. I have this rail and these fasteners, which are made of metal. And I have this box, transport box. Let's name it that. That is also made of metal. But this one is a prop. So if we look at it in the game, I can grab this and we can see that it is dynamic. I've named all the objects and I put them in this group, joints demo. When you're working with groups, compounds and bodies, it's good to know that this gizmo, the origin point of the group or the body or the compound, can be moved by holding down the control key, like this. And since this is the point that the group will rotate around, it can be useful to be able to move this gizmo now and then. You can also press the O key to place the gizmo at the bottom center of the group, body, or compound. But back to the joints. So I select this transport box. I right click it. I select new and a joint. And I move the joint up there and to the about the middle of the box. And I move it in there. And then in the type field, I type prismatic. And again, just like the hinge, we can see that we have this yellow indicator showing what direction the prismatic joint is moving. And the prismatic joint is a joint that is moving along a line. So if I rotate this 90 degrees here and I press the F key to move in on the selected object, in this case the prismatic joint, we can see that this circle of the joint doesn't touch the rail. And that means that this joint will not connect the transport box with the rail. So what I can do is either increase the size of the joint to 0.2 instead of 0.1. And now it will properly connect to the rail. Or I can leave it at default, bring up my snap window, change the move snap to 0.5, and I can move this joint up half a voxel, so it's in between these two objects. And now it should grab onto them. I reset my move snap back to 1. Nope, that wasn't enough. So I go back and I change the size of the joint to 0.15. That should be enough. And here we can see the prismatic joint in action. A problem is that it will just continue like this forever. So, goodbye transport box. But there is a solution to that. Just like the hinge joint had a rotational limits, the prismatic joint also has limits. So this is the optional min and max angle of hinge rotation. It says angle here, but for the prismatic joint, it's the amount of allowed travel. So if I type 0 and 5, I get these indicators, this blue line here and this blue line here, which are 5 meters apart. And we can see that the box stops at those ends. I I can set it to -1 meter here. So we have the stop back here. And we can set it to, let's see, maybe 20. 22. Oh, that was too much. 20.5. That's good. And now the transport box correctly travels along this rail. Another problem is that if I now break the rail, the transport box will still continue like the rail was still there. But there's a solution to that as well. Select the joint. And here we have a property called auto-disable. For prismatic joint, disable when sliding apart. So I set this to true. And now let's take a look in the game. We have the correctly working transport box on the rail. And if I destroy the rail, it will correctly fall off where the rail is broken. And that's all for the video on prismatic joints.